Unless you were involved in the development of a bouldering area, all you have to go on is the advice of people you see there and what you read in the book in relation to pictures in the book, one hopes. But books aren't always that explicit and things change through time. So there can be a lot of controversy on what later constitutes a valid beta. For example, here we have Sonom, which is the first V4 that I ever climbed in Val David. Now, it's a nice problem. I quite enjoyed climbing it, but I think that the beta I used is quite different from the original intent of the beta, because I think a new hold has appeared. So the original beta, I believe, was to start underneath here and follow just along this edge here. But then, at some point in the last 5 years maybe, a flake broke here, creating a very obvious edge here. And for a tall person, at least, that makes it much easier. Let's take a look at what did that. So I wanted to go back and do it without this flake. Much nicer problem that way. This is one of the most unique boulder problems you're going to find anywhere. It's called La Proue, and it involves just ascending this spectacular prow here. Now, it's hard to know what the OG beta was for this, but one would logically think it would be a sit start, right? There's a decent hold here. Grab the prow, and up you go. Now, what often happens with these old bouldering areas with old boulders that later became popular is that the ground gets really compacted. Now, the ground here could easily be 15 centimeters further down than it was originally, which would make a sit start really hard on this. So instead, what people do is now they do it as a crouch start. And that basically involves putting a foot here, flagging over there, and putting a left hand right here. So when we first filmed this, with Cedar doing it, she did it this way.
Nice, Cedar, come on.
Nice, that's a better pop-out. But then I came back later and wondered, with my height, I could perhaps do the original, I think probably the original sit start.
Yeah,
yeah.
For like 1 year. The year I started climbing.
Come on.
And
Ali.
Nice job.
This was sketchy.
It's much more fun that way. Matter of fact, I think it's actually easier if you're tall to do the sit start than it is to do this scrunched up thing with this really bad foot here. One of the trickier things about climbing a boulder problem later on, well after it was set, is that things change. And so the holds you're supposed to use and the way in which you're supposed to move is different. So this boulder has a beautiful problem, stand start V3, but also has a 4-5 sit start. Now, the sit start is kind of crazy because it's just kind of horrible positioning. And it seems almost inevitable through compression that the bottom is lower than it used to be, which means that the sit start is just ridiculously awkward. So what's much more natural now is to start entirely on the arete here. And then after a move or two, a big move for me to here, go around the corner to this. So when I sent this problem, I used this here. Now, I'm guessing that wasn't originally used on the sit start of Yperon Classique, but it's the natural movement now. And so now you can still do it with the sit start around here, not using that. It's just harder.
C'est quoi, je pile. Non, comme ça. Talent. Ouais. Plus haut. Good job.
This is the Eric Boulder in Les Hommes. And there's a famous traverse on it called Eric Traverse, which is a hard V4. But there's also a variation where you just start on the ledge here and go straight up. And it's a 4-5, and there's a bunch of different betas for it. Some people do a static version where they just rock up, lock off, and reach.
Yes.
Yes. Fuck yeah.
J'ai aimé le pinky move.
Tu fais un pinky move?
Ouais.
Other people do a much more dynamic version where they just use a low foot and just jump for the lip. I did kind of a combination version where I got a heel on, but then I didn't lock off and go static. I kind of went semi-dynamic from there. And so that's three very different betas to the same problem, all of which are graded roughly 4 or 5. But there's one other logical beta which is expressly forbidden, and that's to use the arete over there. So the book explicitly says to leave off the arete. But I think it's a nice V3-4 if you do use the arete. So there's some discussion about what the proper start is on sarcophage here. The book basically says you start on the left side of the overall rock, which we're doing here, but then where precisely to start here and whether sitting or standing. Clearly it's supposed to be a sit start, but there seem to be two versions in the book. The V5 just says anywhere on this ledge.
Come on! Allez!
Fuck!
Allez, come on, come on! Allez, c'est fini, hein!
And the V6 says to start over here, with both hands over here, and then traverse into it.
Come on. Yes.
Allez.
Nice. Allez.
Allez, on va.
Oui. Yes. Come on. Come on.
Come on. Oh,
allez.
Okay. Oh, heel toe, ici, c'est comment? Prends ton temps. Colle-toi.
Ouais.
Ouais.
Ouais. Ouais. Ouais. Yes. Come on. Prends la main gauche. Garde la main droite où elle était, puis replace la main gauche.
Allez, prends ton temps, prends ton temps. Là, t'es trop you loin du mur. Voilà.
Oui.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah.
Yes, là t'es bien.
Mental,
mental, mental.
Replace
ta gueule. Allez,
yeah.
Allez,
oui. Allez. Bon, nice. Parfait, nice.
Or I suppose it's also possible that there's a start further over here, but I don't know. Anyway.